It is now about an hour and 45 minutes to launch. You're looking at the scene from high above. The Goodyear blimp orbiting at a safe distance around the Kennedy Space Center. We're told about 12 miles away. That's about how much airspace they clear off for this aircraft. The Space Shuttle Discovery, scheduled now for liftoff in less than an hour and 45 minutes. And providing our coverage from above is the blimp Stars and Stripes at the controls, Captain Jim Maloney, from Vienna, Virginia. This year is Goodyear is celebrating its 100-year anniversary and 72-year anniversary for its blimp fleet. There is the Stars and Stripes, an appropriate name for a blimp on a day like today, I should say. Mark Potter is somewhere beneath the Goodyear blimp right now with the group on the beach, ready to see the show. Hello, Mark.
Hello, Miles. Well, we are in a sea of people, 8,000 people to be specific, here in Titusville. Everyone is just waiting quietly. People are hunkered down now. The excitement of early this morning has settled down a bit. People are just waiting for the launch at 2 o'clock. The main thing they're having to deal with here right now is the heat. It's a very hot day, and everyone is just doing what they can to keep cool. Umbrellas are precious commodities, as you can see here in this area right now, which looks like a beachhead. Actually, it is sort of one. We're on the bank of the Indian River, about 10 miles from the launch pad area, and surprisingly, 10 miles away, we can still see the pad. We can certainly see the vehicle assembly building. It's going to be quite a show here, and everyone knows that, and they're just waiting for the time to pass so that they can watch it. And we're being kept apprised here by a loudspeaker system over the hill of exactly how things are going, so people know where we stand and how much more time we have to go. Now, people are here from all over the country. And, in fact, we met a couple here from Sydney, Australia. They came here just for this launch. Some of the people who are here from this country include Gary Thompson. Gary, we tried to talk to you earlier, but we were interrupted by the astronauts. You came all the way from Perryville, Maryland. Tell me why you thought it was so important to be here.
Well, just a history. I went to see John Glenn go back up in space again.
And what's so important about this mission as far as you're concerned?
Well, I think it's going to give a boost to the space program that, for further funding and whatnot. I just think that the space program needs a shot in the arm right now.
And this will do it.
I believe so. You see the people here.
Exactly. Alice and Bob Wills are here from Cleveland, Ohio, the state where Senator Glenn is from.
Right.
Tell me why you thought it was so important to come here for this.
Well, we wanted to represent our city, which is a space town with NASA there and also a great city to live, and our family and our church from Grace Baptist, and Glenn has always been real special to us.
And so what do you think about seeing him return to space 36 years later?
I think it's fantastic. I just admire a man that's 77 that can actually go back to where he's been and just be really important to his country.
And Bob, what do you think about the importance of this to the country itself?
Well, it's the first one I've ever seen live, and I'm really going to enjoy that. But John's kind of special to us, and we'd like to see him go up the second time. I saw him on TV go up the first time. And you kind of look at somebody else, and it was over. So this one, he's really going to enjoy going up.
And there's been some controversy about this flight. Some people are critical, saying that the science is not real science, that it's just a pretext for a nostalgic visit back. What do you think about that?
Well,
or does it matter?
I really don't know whether that's true or not, but I know what does matter, and that is John is getting everybody all excited again about going up to space. And that's what NASA's whole program needed, is a kind of a shot in the arm of the people getting back into it. So I think if nothing else, that is a real value.
Well, we appreciate talking with all of you. Enjoy the show. It's going
to
be quite some show here. We're going to have a good view right over here to the left of the VAB, the vehicle assembly building, and we're all looking forward to it. Again, a crowd of 8,000 people here, an estimated crowd of 250,000 to 300,000 in the entire Brevard County area here watching this event. Miles, back to you.
All right, Mark Potter enjoying himself out there. Once again, a spectacular view on a spectacular day from the Goodyear blimp as we look at Florida's Space Ghost in preparation for the launch of Discovery. Six people and a seventh by the name of John Glenn. His second historic flight into space is now an hour and 20 minutes away, if things go according to plan. Stay with CNN for extensive live coverage of this event. We'll take a break right now.